All right, guys, welcome to this Maths Tutorials. My name is Samuel Dikwede, and I'm going to continue the Maths Tutorials for private exam, June exam, and this will be relevant for grade 11 and 12. Now, I want to give you a preamble. Our topic of discussion is going to be bearings, but I want to give you a preamble. We have to know this before you start this particular topic. So let's look at sine rule, sine and cosine. It is the application of sine and cosine that we find in the bearing. So we'll look at sine rule. What's sine rule? If I have a triangle, let's say A, B, C. Now we have acute angle triangles here. The side opposite the angle is its own side. So angle A, this side is opposite the angle, so it's small letter A. This is the side, this is the angle. Now we also have side B there, and we have side C there. So small letter is side, and capital letter is the angle. So the sine rule says the ratio of the side and its trigonometry, the sine of its angle, are in constant proportion. That is sine B is also equal to C over sine C. That is the sine rule. What about the cosine rule? The cosine rule, let's say we have an obtuse angle triangle like that. So I have A, B, C. This is the side opposite B is its own side. Side opposite this is its own side. This one too is that. So for cosine rule, we want to find the sides. It's B square, A square plus C square minus 2AC cos of the angle itself. Cos of the angle B. If I want to find A also, it's B square plus C square minus 2BC cos of A. If I want to find C, that is the side C, it's going to be B square. Let me start with A square plus B square minus 2AB, and you have cos of C. So you can find the side of this triangle and also find the angle attached. So let me take one. So if I say B square is equal to A square plus C square minus 2AC cos B, then I can transpose this. I can transpose this here. I have 2AC cos B is equal to, then I can transpose this sort of one too. So I have A square plus C square minus B square. So I'm sending this over there. So now this is 2AC divided by 2AC. So this guy, here we go. So I have cos B as equal to A square plus C square minus B square all over 2A, 2AC. So I can find the angle and I can find the side. So I can find the angle from cosine. I can also find the side. So these two applications are what we're going to use to actually get into bearings. But let's see how we can apply this in real situation. So let's look at this triangle. Let's say this triangle is 60 degrees there, and this is also 4 centimeters, let's say 6 centimeters, and I have 40 centimeter here. Then I want to find this. So I can find this is opposite that. So that is 6 sine 60 is equal to find that angle, that side B over sine 40. So if I want to make B the subject of the formula, that is sine 60 is 6 sine 40. So I divide here by sine 60, I divide here by sine 60, such that this will vanish. So I have B equals to 6 sine 40 all over sine 60. So you punch this from the calculator, have 6 sine 60, 6 sine 40. Giving you that 6 times 40 is, you can use your calculator to verify something here. It's 6, 5, 6, 7 divided by 0.8660. So divide by 0.8660. So it gives you 4.5. So B is equal to 4.5. So I've got this side here as 4.5. This is 6. This is 4.5. So I can also apply. I can use this. Let me give another example for cosine. Let's say I want to find this. I have this side here as 4 centimeters. I have this side here as 5 centimeters. Now I want to find that distance. Let's say this is 120 degrees. So I can find B squared is equal to, this is A squared, we said, plus C squared minus 2AC cos of capital B. So if I want to find this, it's B squared is equal to A squared, which is 4 squared, plus C squared, which is 5 squared, minus 2 into 4 times 5 cos of 120. So B squared is equal to 16 plus 25 minus 2 into 20. Then you have, this is minus 0.5. That is cos 120, it's minus 0.5. So we have, if you put this together, you have 41, then minus 40, then into minus 0.5. This is 2 times 20 is 40. This plus this is 41. So have B squared. Be careful, you don't subtract before clear the brackets. You clear the bracket here first. So minus times minus is plus. Then 40 times that is 20. Then I have 41 there. Be careful here. You don't subtract before you clear the bracket. Board maths. You have to clear the bracket first. So minus times minus is plus. 40 times 0.5 is 20. So I have 61. So I have B squared. So B is equal to root of 61. So B is equal to, if I check the root of 61, root of 61 will give you 7.8. So I have 7.8 centimeter. So I've applied the sine rule to get that side, and I've applied the cosine rule to get that other side. So now it is these two applications that are going to be found in bearing. So if you want to really operate bearing, you understand the concept of bearing, you must try to know the sine and cosine, because those are the applications. So we now want to start the lessons proper. This is the application. It says sine rule. I go over that. Sine rule says the side divided by its trigonometric sine of its angle are in constant proportion. And we also looked at the cosine formula. We can use the cosine formula where we have two sides given and the included angle. You find the other side. In using sine rule, you have to get a complete information. Each side and the corresponding angle must be available for you to use sine rule. For cosine rule, you must have two sides given to you, and you find the other side and the included angle given. So you can as well use cosine here or sine here. It's possible, you can interchange them. So let's go to the application. Now we are going to use this and apply it in the concept of bearing. So watch out for this. This is the application, and we are going to use it now to enter the bearing proper. So that was just a preamble for you to understand what we are supposed to do. So if you understand this concept, the questions are basically on these two ideas. So this is how you operate the cosine formula and the sine rule. So let's proceed now.